Good evening, students. Today we are going to start with the second half of our select statement topic. In our previous topic, we have seen DML commands. DML commands is data manipulation language. In this commands, we have started with select statement, which is used for retrieving the data the way you want. Then in select statement, we have seen all clause, then distinct clause, like clause. Okay, now today we are going to emphasis more on select statements and other DML queries. Select statement is also having between clause, which is used for retrieving the data between the given range. For example, if I want to retrieve the details of employee whose salary is in between say 2000 to 5000, then I will use select star from employee where age or salary between 2000 and 5000. So 2000 and 5000 values will also get included in it, and the values in between them will also get displayed. Okay, then there is in clause. See, if you know the specific values, if I want a record of employees whose age is only 30 or 40, I don't want in between values, directly 30 and 40, then I'll use in clause. For example, if I want to display the employees having age 30 and 40, then I'll say select star from employee where age in 30 comma 40. So only the record of employees having age 30 and 40 will get displayed. So that is about in clause. Okay, you can see other examples of in clause. Then if while creating table you give the short names for the tables, short names for the columns, but while retrieving the data, if you want to change the column name for temporary basis, then you can use column alias by using as keyword. Okay, so if I want to display e name as employee name, then I'll say select e name as, so here as is a column alias, where as employee name from employee, so employee name will get replaced by e name. Okay, for at least for that time being, that is about column alias. Okay, then if I want to update the data, okay, if I want to update the say name, then update is also what DML query, which is used for updating data. So if I say update employee, set is a keyword, set ename is equal to Rucha where e-number is equal to 4. So those who are having employee number as 4, change their e-name, make it Rucha. So that will get updated. So you can see in the record now employee number 4 is having name Rucha. Initially it was Siddhi. Okay. Then if I want to update with the null values, if I want to set the null values, then I will say update employee set salary is equal to null. So your null is a keyword. Null means empty, neither zero nor any value, where e name is equal to Sahil. So null value will get displayed for particular employee Sahil. Okay, if I want to change the date, then I will use again set keyword, set DOP. DOP here is the column name holding the date of birth. I'll set the date of birth of Rutu. Okay. Then we will turn towards group by functions. Group by functions are the functions which are called as aggregate functions, which are applied on a whole group. So group by functions are like average, count, minimum, maximum, sum, okay, variance. So out of this all, we will be emphasis on minimum, maximum, average, mean and count. Okay, first we'll see average function. Average function will do the work of addition of all the values and divided by total number of records, so it will give you the average value. Maximum function will display the maximum out of the given values. Minimum function will give you the minimum out of the given specific values. Sum function will calculate or do the addition of all the values. Count function will count all the records excluding null records. Null records will not be included in the count function. Okay, this group by statements groups the rows that have same values. Suppose you want to group the average, you want to do it, remove the average based on the group of department. Then you will use select average of the salary from employee group by department ID. So department wise the average will be calculated. Okay, department A, department B, department C. So all these three departments will have their group by average. Order by clause is used to arrange the sequence. Suppose when you're purchasing something on Amazon, you have the option of sort. So here order by is same like sorting. If you want to arrange the values in ascending or you want to arrange the values in descending, you will use order by clause. Join clause is used to execute two different tables at the same time. If I want to fetch the record of employee table as well as of department table at the same time, I'll use the join. Okay, so this all is the second half of your this thing, select statement. All what you're going to do is you're going to execute this all at your home on MySQL setup. Try to solve. If you have any difficulty, see, this is not that difficult. Once you will start solving it, you will find it very easy. So try to solve it on the computer. Okay, first try to create the table, create a database, create the table, try to fill at least 10 to 20 records in the table. After entering the records in the table, try to apply simple select queries using like, all, distinct, okay, columnalize, then order by, and later on you start with the aggregate functions like minimum, average, count, maximum, and group by clause. So it will be easy for you to understand. You also try to make use of in clause, between clause. Okay, so this is up to the select statement in which we have covered till select. We have just started with update. The next queries which we are going to emphasize are delete queries. After delete, we will be concentrating on which other queries: delete, update, insert. Insert you already have learned. Okay, so you try to create the table. So the homework for you all is create table with the name student. Try to make the entries subject wise. Okay, admission date wise, GR number, try to create the columns in it and fill the data up to 20 records so that it will be easy for you for applying all the queries with the result. What I want from you all is you have to do this and you have to send me the screenshots, okay, of the table which you have created with the queries which you have created. So that all is been expected from you, then only I'll move further for the next lecture. Okay, if you have any queries, just put the queries on WhatsApp and your queries will get resolved. Is it clear? Okay, see, SQL is very important and very easy to understand. No need to get tense. Once you install SQL at your home, you will understand it properly. Is it clear? Okay, then bye. Have a good day. Take care. Try to solve all the SQL examples at your home. Okay, I'll just end the lecture. Okay, bye.